your 11 Insta-Weather Plus forecast with Chief Meteorologist Tom Tasselmeyer.
It's classic mid-Atlantic weather when you hit mid-90s, even upper 90s in downtown Baltimore, and it actually feels a little more comfortable. Got rid of some of the humidity. Drier air swept into the region today, but those temperatures really have not cooled off all that much yet. That probably will happen tomorrow. We're hoping that tomorrow, actually, most areas will stay below the 90-degree mark. But today, 95 at the airport, 97 at the Inner Harbor. The normal is only 87, but that normal high is actually a degree lower than yesterday's normal high. So we've hit the hottest part of the season, actually made our way through it, and now the normal high temperatures will slowly start to taper off. 87 today. It'll stay at 87 for a few days, and gradually this normal high will continue to lower. Record high for the day, 101 degrees. That is safe, even though we made it to 95 at the airport. The record is intact. 90-degree days are totaling up now to 29 so far this year. Through the 26th of July last year, we had 39 days above 90. We've actually had more so far this July, though, than last year. And last year was a record-setting pace. We ended up with 59 90-degree days for the whole season. We'll see if we get that many this year. We still got the entire month of August to go and into September. 100-degree days last year in 2010. We had 7 days with temperatures above 100. The hottest was 105. So far this year, summer, we've had 4 100-degree days, and the hottest one last Friday at 106 degrees. It's still hot all across central and eastern Maryland. No report from Ocean City or Salisbury, but Easton and Ridgely up near the 90-degree mark cooled off a couple degrees at Hancock in the past hour. But the big difference today is the dew point. The lower the dew point, the drier the air. Yesterday, dew point readings were in the 70s and it felt very humid. Today, dew point readings in the 50s and it feels a little drier. There's actually a cold front coming across Pennsylvania now. Severe thunderstorms, Poconos, Catskills into southern New England, and a trailing line of isolated storms all the way back toward western Maryland. That front, as it slides through Baltimore tonight, might trigger a brief shower or sprinkle as it makes its way through central Maryland, but most of the storms look like they'll fall apart. The good news is the front moves off the coast, and the temperatures may actually cool off a couple degrees. 60s for most areas by morning tomorrow. Sun goes down this evening at 8:25, and after that front moves by, the winds will shift to the west. Sitting behind the front, up over the Great Lakes and into southern Canada, some very comfortable air, and at least a part of that will filter into our region. Stick around for Wednesday. Maybe not as long as Thursday. By Thursday, things are going to start to heat up again. But at least for a day tomorrow, it'll technically feel a little bit cooler. 87 to 92 degrees with low humidity and a comfortable northwest breeze. On the bay tomorrow, 5 to 10 knot wind. Waves around a foot. Bay water temperatures in the mid-80s. Sunny and comfortable in the mountains tomorrow. Temperatures dropping into the 50s out west tomorrow night. Around the bay, just below the 90-degree mark, and with low humidity, it should be beautiful. St. Michael's and Cambridge, lower eastern shore, same scenario. Sunny skies, a touch cooler, and thankfully not too humid. But the summertime heat and humidity come back. We're into the low 90s Thursday, mid to upper 90s Friday and Saturday, and there is that 30% chance of an afternoon storm throughout the weekend.